scared Maxine goes into hiding as Trump whacks her hard with dose of brutal justice. Mad Maxine Waters is strangely absent from all public appearances in what can only be described as the Congresswoman intentionally hiding out. This has been going on for a couple weeks, and now we know why. Yesterday, President Donald Trump turned the tables on Whacky Waters, becoming her worst nightmare. Maxine is scared, and she should be. Trump's caught her red-handed in a sting operation, and now, she's getting a dose of brutal justice. Most Americans recognize Mad Maxine Waters as the most obnoxious voice leading the Impeach 45 campaign. Whacky Waters refused to attend the inauguration for President Donald Trump, and she was already calling for impeachment on January 20, 2017. Imagine that, calling for a president to be impeached before he has even spent one full day in office. That's how delusional and downright obsessed this lawmaking is. So, right away the warning bells went off. The California congresswoman was adamant Trump colluded with Russia, and she coined the phrase the Kremlin clan. When it became evident that the allegations against Trump were not only untrue but that it was the president who has been set up by a cabal working in the Obama administration, along with his holdovers within the FBI and DOJ, you'd think Auntie Maxine would tone it down a bit. Instead, she doubled down and became a running joke among most Trump supporters. Conservative pundit Deneen Borelli does an excellent job of extracting the worst of Maxine Waters in 2017. Pay attention to Whacky Waters' statements in the short video that was posted on Twitter. Now, for the bombshell information that is causing Maxine Waters to disappear from public view. As we laid out, Waters is in deep, refusing to stop her calls for impeachment, even when other Democrats started to pull back from the bogus Trump-Russia collusion narrative in mid-November. Special Counsel Robert Mueller's investigation was always a sham to cover up the biggest political scandal of modern times, and Waters is smack in the middle of it. Yesterday, Senator Dianne Feinstein released the transcripts of Fusion GPS CEO Glenn Simpson's testimony before the Senate Intel Committee. Why? She's scared. Feinstein knows it's only a matter of time before the entire fake Mueller investigation and the Obama cabal is fully exposed. Immediately after Feinstein released those documents, Trump's attorneys filed a defamation lawsuit against Fusion GPS. In case you missed it, Fusion GPS is the firm the Hillary Clinton campaign hired to dig up opposition research on Trump. They compiled the infamous Russian dossier, also referred to as the Steele dossier. They also worked in collusion with Barack Obama's cabal to spy on Donald Trump. Fox News reports, Michael Cohen, one of President Trump's personal attorneys, filed a defamation action Tuesday against BuzzFeed News and its editor-in-chief over allegations about him that were published in the now infamous Trump-Russia dossier compiled by a former British spy. So, what does this have to do with Maxine Waters? Everything. Let's back up and review. What politician has been quoting directly from the bogus Russian dossier, presenting it as fact and smearing Donald Trump's name? Yep, good ole Auntie Maxine. Now, Trump's attorney, Michael Cohen, is filing on behalf of himself, but it's a legal maneuver. It forces Fusion GPS to lay open all their sources, and they are not protected as classified because they aren't even part of the government. I'm betting Mad Maxine has shut her trap and is hiding out for the same reason that Dianne Feinstein made the Fusion GPS testimony public. They see what is coming, and it's not good. For Auntie Maxine, it may lead to potential criminal charges. Why? Well, remember Obama's cabal of rogue FBI and DOJ personnel, including James Comey, Loretta Lynch, Sally Yates, Peter Sturzok, Lisa Page, Bruce Orr, and Andy McCabe, just to name a few, were spying on then-candidate Donald Trump and his campaign. Now, guess which Obama insider knew all about Barack's rogue collection of data on U.S. citizens, also known as illegal spying? Yes, Maxine Waters. Let's go to 2013 when Mad Maxine was in an interview with Roland Martin and he talked about how the Democrats might be in trouble come 2016. Martin said, but it also represented the countdown of the end of his, Obama's, presidency. The reality is, like anything else, You better get what you can while he's there because, look, come 2016, that's it. Waters replied, the thing I think some people are missing here is the president has put in place an organization that contains the kind of database that no one has ever seen before in life that's going to be very, very powerful. Waters continued, that database will have information about everything on every individual in ways that it's never been done before. That sounds like communist China to me, and that shocking statement, made clear back in 2013, is now going to haunt her now. The Obama cabal, FBI, and DOJ traitors wired up to Donald Trump by utilizing that database, collecting data on U.S. citizens, but what they did when it came to Trump is unmask those private communications, illegally unmasking Trump and his campaign people. It's no wonder Mad Maxine was all in as the lead big mouth, pushing this bogus conspiracy. She had the inside information on Barack Obama's powerful database and was sure they would never be caught. Exactly how much Mad Maxine knew, we have no idea, but there is no doubt she was part of Obama's cabal from the very beginning, and the end game was a constitutional crisis that would have burned this country down. So, say goodbye to Mad Maxine Waters, she really is living up to her nickname Poverty Pimp and circling the swamp drain.